Pivoting is a technique that provides an easy way to transform row values into columns with a subquery. Here is a table named Sales 3, and it has 5 columns: year, quarter, area, units, and sales amount. This table has 48 rows with sales data for 3 years, 2018 through 2020. Let's say we want to pivot on the area column to produce a result that shows sales in units sold for each area by year. You aren't sure if you should manually specify the area values in the in list of your pivot query. Instead of manually specifying the area values in the in list, we can simply replace the hard-coded values with a subquery. That's a huge time saver for you. In this example, our pivot column is area. And instead of hard-coding the values north, south, east, and west, we are doing a subselect to get the distinct values in the area column of our sales 3 table, which the pivot operation uses to generate the resulting columns. And by the way, if we had a secondary table, like a lookup table with the area values, the pivot function would allow us to use that table in our subselect. Now let's run this SQL statement. Notice that our pivot query returns 3 rows from our 48-row table, and it has returned not 5, but 9 columns. It transformed the values from the rows in the area column into their own columns, each one storing the sum of that quarter's sales in units sold by year. And we did this without having to hard-code the area values in our pivot query's in list. So, now I bet you're saying, hey, that's great. I'm always going to use the subquery in my pivot query instead of hard-coding values in the in list. That's great that you feel that way, but there might be times that you can't. Let me explain. In this example, we're again using a subquery in the in list and following it with a with clause for a summary total. Let's submit this SQL statement. Unfortunately, the with clause is not supported in pivot with a subquery in list. You'll get an error when trying to use them together. You can fix that by using constants in the place of the subquery. In this query, we replace the subquery with string literals of the values we know to be in the table. By doing this, we can keep our with clause. Let's run the query. Notice that this time it runs without error. Another rule to consider is that the subquery in your pivot query can return no more than a maximum of 16 values. Otherwise, we'll get an error. In this video, I showed how pivoting using a subquery is an easy way to transform row values into columns.